Hi and welcome. My name is Dr. Gail Roboz, and I am the director of the Leukemia Program at Weill Cornell Medical College and the New York Presbyterian Hospital in New York City. I'm also a member of the MDS CRC, or Clinical Research Consortium, and you can find out more about us and our six member sites on crushmds.org. Today, I'd like to speak about a clinical trial that we have available for patients with chronic myelomonocytic leukemia, or CMML. I have to tell you, this diagnosis drives patients, their family members, and also our fellows and medical students a little bit crazy, because it's a diagnosis that sounds like another disease, CML, or chronic myeloid leukemia, but actually is completely different. I know the initials are only separated by the letter O, CML versus CMMOL, but I've got to tell you, they're completely different diseases, and I think it comes as a bit of a surprise for patients to realize that chronic myelomonocytic leukemia actually falls into a kind of between position. It's between a myelodysplastic syndrome and a myeloproliferative disorder. Just what I've said so far is usually enough to give most people a big headache because they're very difficult to understand terms. So I want to try to make it a little bit simpler. All of these diseases are diseases of the bone marrow, and the bone marrow is the organ in your body that makes blood cells, white blood cells that fight infection, red blood cells that carry around oxygen, and platelets, the little tiny cells that help you clot if you get a cut. Sometimes the bone marrow doesn't know how many of each cell type to produce, and it might make too many white blood cells, too few red blood cells, and platelets can be in either direction, too many or too few. And the relative proportion of these different blood cells is what helps to define whether somebody has a myeloproliferative disorder, or a bone marrow problem where you make too many cells, or a myelodysplastic syndrome, which usually results in too few. Chronic myelomonocytic leukemia actually falls in between because usually patients have too many white blood cells and sometimes too few red blood cells, leading to anemia. So the bone marrow is confused. It's making too many of one thing, too few of another, and the platelets can either go up or down. Patients who are diagnosed with chronic myelomonocytic leukemia may actually benefit from one of the FDA-approved therapies for MDS, but actually we're trying to see if other therapies might be of use for this patient population. And there is yet another FDA-approved medication called ruxolitinib, or Jakafi, which is approved for a different bone marrow disorder, just to make things even more complicated. There is a bone marrow disease called myelofibrosis, and this medication, ruxolitinib, is FDA approved for the treatment of myelofibrosis. However, researchers at the Moffitt Cancer Center in Florida, a member site of the CRC, have data suggesting that this particular medication might also be of specific benefit for patients with CMML, or chronic myelomonocytic leukemia. The medication is very well tolerated for many patients, and the scientific data and some very preliminary clinical data suggest that this unusual disease, CMML, might be another area where ruxolitinib can be of help. Please check out with your doctor, if you're a patient with CMML, whether this trial might be of benefit to you, or feel free to call any of us at the participating sites for more information. You can visit the website at crushmds.org. Thank you.